Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is another video in the tips and tricks. Mostly it is in Power Query. So one of the topic I'm going to discuss today is a pivot table. And before talking about pivot table, all my tips and tricks playlist, mostly it is related to Power Query. So I didn't have a dedicated playlist for Power Query because of this. With this note, let's try to begin today's topic. So pivot is nothing but converting your rows into columns. That is a simple definition of it. And if you are from SQL background, you are already aware of this terminology and you might have used it. The same concept we are going to apply it in Power Query. That is, we are going to convert a rows into columns. And what scenarios will you use it? Let's try to discuss in this video. And I want to make this video or frequently viewing this channel somewhat interactive. So I have a challenge for you at the end of this video. So once you can crack this challenge, you can post it in the comments or you can email the solution to us so that we can publish in our next video who have solved this challenge. With this note, let us try to begin. So as I said before, we are in Power Query now and we have a simple data set here. That is, project wise you have different stages. So each project has 5 stages: kickoff, execution, and you have a start date. And this particular project has 5 stages and have a date. So basically, in some reports or some charts, we need these columns, right? I mean, these data, kickoff, to be in the column. Kickoff date, execution date, UAT date, go live date, maintenance date, something like that. So how to do it? Like, you can click on it, which column you want to do a pivot, go to transform and click on pivot column. Then here you need to choose what values to be present under that column. Here, once you choose that column, remaining columns will appear. So you choose start date, then go here in count. Usually it will be aggregation, right? So whether the sum of sales to be present, so some kind of stuff. Here date doesn't have a count. Instead you can go for maximum of date. So once you click on it, now you can see from the previous step, the kickoff for 005 project is 01/2020 and execution 16/1. So here 005 project 01/01, 16/1 is the execution date. So now you have 5 columns over here. And this is what a pivot is: converting a rows into different columns. This is more simple when you have 3 columns like this. But what if the data having multiple columns, you need to pivot it, right? What I'm trying to say is, this is the same data set. I have only another column. Okay, I will remove that column for simplicity. So assume you have this particular data set and you have one more column called completion date here. So instead of having for each project 5 rows, I need to have 10 columns. Sorry, instead of having 5 columns here, right? For each stage, you have 5 columns. In this case, I need to have 10 columns. Kickoff start date, one column. Kickoff completion date, another column. Execution start date, execution completion date. Like that. So each stages will have 2 columns, 5 into 2. Equal to 10 columns. So how you can do it, right? That is the challenge for you, and I will share this data along with this Power BI file. You can work out and provide the solution. With this note, if you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Since 60% of this channel viewers are not yet subscribed yet, which will motivate us to do more. And do remember that data is your asset.